Welcome to Morning Manna with Pastor Steve Myrie. Today's topic, it's not what it looks like. Part 2 of 2 parts. And Peter answered him and said, Lord, if it be thou, bid me to come unto thee on the water. And he said, come. And when Peter was come down out of the ship, he walked on water to go to Jesus. But when he saw the wind boisterous, he was afraid and began to sink and cried out, saying, Lord, save me. Matthew 14, 28 through to 30. Satan's desire is to get our attention off what really is happening and make us believe what's not real. Jesus called Peter out of the boat to walk on water with him. And as long as he kept his eyes on Jesus, he was all right. But something distracted him. Maybe it was the howl of the wind that began to break through his ears. But something happened to destroy his focus on the Master. Can I speak to a Peter out there today? If you're going to walk on water, you can't watch the wind. You must watch Jesus. The wind, although it appears real, and the waves, although you can feel the spray pounding your face, it's just an optic illusion when your eyes are on Jesus. David came to the Valley of Elah one day to bring food for his brothers. Now by the time David arrived on the scene, Goliath had already been stepping out into the valley and breathing out threats. And for 40 days, Saul and his mighty warriors would focus on the giant of the Philistines. And that's where their gaze would rest. They could never get around his threat, his size, the booming of his voice as it echoes across the valley like a thunderous claps. They could never bring themselves to believe the promise of God that he would deliver them from the uncircumcised Philistine. The evidence appeared to indicate that the giant was going to conquer Israel, and there was nothing anyone could do about it. But along came a 17-year-old boy who was too naive or too full of the Spirit of God or too arrogant to bow down to the problem, no matter how big he is. Now, here's the kicker. Saul and his army and David were both looking at the same problem. Yet Saul decided that the giant was too large to eliminate, and David never even called him a giant. Saul's gaze stopped on Goliath, but David said, I'm going to look a little higher. You can stop with the problem, but I'm going to proceed to the problem solver. Saul's gaze stopped on Goliath, and fear kept him in his tent. But David said that this is an optical illusion. I will not look at the uncircumcised Philistine in the valley. I will lift mine eyes to the hills, from whence cometh my help. Saul's problem was he was not looking high enough. It's not what it looks like. Get your eyes on Jesus and off the false evidence. It is the plan of the enemy to get us to focus on our problems and our current circumstances. The lack of money in the bank, the lack of spiritual hunger on the behalf of your family members right now. And I know they are very serious issues, and the evidence appear to be real, and the circumstances appear to be very tangible. But I came by here to tell somebody this morning, I'm praying that God will open your eyes and the spirit so that you can see today you're not going under, you're going over. You're not the tail, you're the head. You're not going to die, you're going to live. What it looks like right now is not what it really is. Can I ask you a question this morning? Whose report will you believe? The devil's report said that you're sick and there's no way that you'll ever recover. But the report of the Lord in Isaiah chapter 53 says, he was wounded for my transgression and bruised for my iniquities. The chastisement of my peace was upon him, and by his stripes I am healed. The devil's reports say that you're broke and God has forsaken you and you're going to lose everything. But Psalm 37 reminds me that I've been young and now I'm old, and I've never seen the righteous forsaken nor his seed begging bread. The devil's report says that you're bound by your addiction and you'll never be free. But the report of the Lord says in Romans 12 verse 2, and be not conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that he may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. Whatever the situation in your life this morning, whatever fear you're facing, whatever false evidence that has been placed in front of you, you need to remember that God is faithful, and the promise he made to you has not died. It's alive. It may appear to be dead, but in reality, it's in process. And you're going to see the fulfillment of that promise, because God cannot lie. It's not what it looks like. The thought of the day. It's not what it looks like. Get your eyes on Jesus and off the false evidence. God bless you today, in Jesus' name.
Please remember to like and subscribe to my page on YouTube. Your support is much appreciated.
Hey, we make a miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness.